1966. But how much longer will they be playing football in Oakland, California? Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Houston Texans and the Oakland Raiders. And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. First carry for Latavius Murray. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll give the Raiders a first down.
To draft a guy in the sixth round and he gives you a 1,000-yard season at some point, would you say he's good value?
That's good return on investment. He was the first Raiders guy to rush for 1,000 yards in 2015 since McFadden back in 2010.
Latavius Murray, remember the name.
They go play action here on first down. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
On first down, Murray. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
All right, here we go. Wide and 8.
That was 2nd down run for Murray. And he'll take this one down to the 36. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They go play action for Murray. Now Carr. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I think the training and practice broke down on that play because he simply didn't run the route deep enough to get to the first down marker, despite what was a really nice catch and toe tap on the sideline.
Well, that's 3rd down, 101. You got to go to the marker, know where it is.
And the 38-year-old vet able to split the uprights. And the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
After the made field goal, here's Sebastian Janikowski to kick it away. Let's chat about the division dominance for the Texans as they come back onto the field. They've won 8 straight games against the AFC South after that Week 10 win.
They've really taken over for Indianapolis, haven't they? Because it wasn't that long ago we were conceding this division to Indianapolis each and every year. Now, it's Houston's. 8 straight, as you just mentioned. Longest active streak in the NFL right now. And by the way, maybe I'm getting ahead of myself, but the Super Bowl is being played in Houston this year.
And this one complete to Will Fuller. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Osweiler. He's got Fuller. And he's brought down. Give him 18 on that one. And the Texans are going to have a first.
And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
One of the things that's really difficult for an offense is often identifying how to block a 3-4 defense. Well, when they're coming on a blitz, even more difficult. They're elusive targets and hard to hit.
So after the mistake by the offense, it cost them 5 yards, and now first and 15. Osweiler. This one complete. It's C.J. Fedorowicz. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is that now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Throwing now, Osweiler on first down. Fuller brings it in over the middle. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
That's caught at the 3. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll make it 2nd and goal. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. On 3rd and goal, Osweiler. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Braxton Miller from 3 yards out. And the Texans have retaken the lead. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
Now it's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. A right side catch by Crabtree. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll be second down. Two minutes gone by, second quarter.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red.
They'll run the option left. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And this is one of those plays that if you can use it to keep the chains moving, it's a good play. And not only that, it tends to tamp down the pass rushers because they have to recognize this play and stay at home. The quarterback uses it well. Read option, keeps it, and picks up a first down with some nice running.
They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
Time and hauled in here by Rivera, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It's a pickup of 19 yards on the play, and that'll make it second and short.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Second down, here's Carr. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. And now out comes Houston. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Hopkins had a frustrating afternoon against the Jags. Targeted 13 times, but caught only 5 balls, 48 yards.
It's been tough for him all year because as the number one receiver, you're not only targeted by your quarterback, you're targeted by the defense as well. 2 and 3 guys in coverage against him, and it was made even worse this past game because Will Fuller didn't play, and neither did Jalen Strong, so they could really focus their attention on DeAndre Hopkins.
He's topped 60 yards only twice this year.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
On second down, here's Osweiler. Miller on the catch over the middle. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Now Osweiler on first down. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Again on second and 10 now, it's Osweiler. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Texans will extend their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Now it's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. Well, Charles, we had one of the best innings, if not the best of the season in Week 10. Will Parks of the Broncos returning that block kick down the sideline. White cleat, white sideline. Did he step out? Hard to tell.
Before I even get to that answer, you know what it reminds me of? A hockey player told me a long time ago, you never wrap your stick with white tape, because then the goalie can find the puck a lot easier. Wrap it with black tape to try and hide it a little bit. We talk about a white shoe on a white sideline. Hard to tell whether he did or didn't. And since the call on the field was he didn't, it had to stand. So that made it really work out well. So if you're going to play, white cleats might be the way to go.
So the offense has it first and 10. On first and 10, here's Carr. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Carr now on first down. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And some options here for the offense on second and 2. Now, Carr again. Here's Wolford over the middle. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. He hit his first. Now this from 43. And Janikowski bangs it through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
Now after the made field goal, here's Sebastian Janikowski to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They come out here in the eye. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So we have reached halftime here. It's the visitors, the Texans, out in front. As we send you cross-country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando with our halftime report, here's Larry Ridley. Here's James. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. And now out comes Houston. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Throwing, Osweiler, right side, caught, Fedorowicz. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. On second down, here's Miller. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
And that's a good sign right there as we start the third quarter, because in the first half, not much space to run the football. And as we go into the half, we often think to ourselves, all right, what's the adjustment? What do they have to do? You know what a lot of the adjustments are? No adjustments. You know the game plan, been working on it all week. Maybe a little tweak here or there, a little bit better blocking, and now you're establishing the running game.
And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. Well, other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
Now it's Osweiler. That is caught at the 7. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. C.J. Fedorowicz, 31 yards. And the Texans will add on to their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. It's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Now Carr throwing on second down. Brought in by Walford, right side. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for 3rd and 4. Shotgun now for Carr. And that's complete to Walford. And he brings this up to the 46, good enough for the first.
Every quarterback likes having a reliable target at tight end, and I think young quarterbacks especially, because they want to get the ball in their hands quickly. I think these two, Derek Carr and Clive Walford, that's a pretty good connection for years to come for Oakland.
Yeah, he started to come on strong end of his rookie year. Now the Raiders really hoping for that second year jump out of Walford.
On 1st and 10, here's Carr. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. No gain, and it's 2nd down. They tried to swing it out left into the flat, but the defense, they were very principled there.
It felt very West Coast offense, didn't it? You know their expression, right? On a West Coast offense, when they throw the ball, it's either going to be a touchdown or a check down, meaning they like to press it downfield. If they don't have it, swing it out, which is exactly what we saw there. But how about the great pursuit and tackle to make a nice play?
And some room to roam now. And the cutback to the sideline. And all the way down to the 7-yard line. A big run that time by Murray. 47 yards on the ground. Murray, the lone setback. He'll get the football here. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Latavius Murray taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Raiders make some inroads here on that deficit.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals before this one they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Here's James. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive.
Back now in the East Bay. It's the Texans in control of the football and leading this game as well as we start the 4th.
second down. Here's Osweiler. The hook up on the right side to Hopkins. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones up to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll throw on first down with Osweiler surveying the field. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, DJ Hayden. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. He's got time. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Throwing his car on third down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Carr, got to have this one. He's got time in the pocket. And this is caught, Amari Cooper. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front. But somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
Murray the lone setback. And he'll get it up the middle. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Latavius Murray, his second touchdown of the night. And the Raiders move back within a couple of the lead.
Well, two touchdowns scored. I know his team's happy. His coaches are happy. How about the fantasy owners of this game?
Always happy with two, but they'd like three or four.
You ready? Red 18.
Now they'll run Murray, but he is not going to make it. It's a big play by the defense, and they're going to hold on to their two-point lead. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Lamar Miller, he's at the 40, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Houston. Lamar Miller, 75 yards, and the Texans will extend their lead. And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
Now it's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. This one taken from the 7. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
Down, Carr out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
All right, here we go.
Now Carr throwing on second down. Brought in by Walford, right side. Call it a gain of 3. And that's going to make it 3rd down and 10. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
Defense has set themselves up nicely. 3rd and 10 now. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, I can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to 4th down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He's gonna let it fly. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Texans take over an excellent field position. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
Down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. A first down carry now for Miller. Fighting his way down. Now whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. Getting down to the end here, they have a 2-score lead. Barely, but it's a 2-score lead, so that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see. What happens here.
Here we go.
Again, it's Miller. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. Now a run. This is Alfred Blue. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Come up in an offset eye. Now a handoff to Miller. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Osweiler to a knee, and that should wrap this one up. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.